Hey everyone, thank you so much for joining me today with Less for Yoga.
Just a reminder to listen to your body, modify or extend as you see fit.
You choose how deep you want to go into your practice. If you'd like, you can grab some yoga blocks, a blanket,
or any articles of clothing for later in our Shavasana. If you have all of those things, let's go ahead and get started in our child's pose.
Into our child's pose, we sit back on the heels, legs are either spread apart or close together. We bring the chest and the forehead down, arms are stretched out front or to the side, and we simply just come into our breath. We take a few inhales and exhales. We inhale through the nose, cleansing the breath, and exhale through the mouth. Let's do this one more time. Take an inhale here. And exhale through the mouth. You can do this as many times as you would like to. Just pause the video. Otherwise, we're going to move on. We're going to take the upper body and move it over to the right side of the yoga mat. Chest will be on top of that right leg. Maybe the left arm crosses over. Really feeling the stretch opening up that left side, those left ribs. Really envisioning that stretch going all the way up the side. And let's bring it back to center. Let's take it over to the left. Left arm comes over to the side. Maybe the right arm crosses over. Chest might be on top of that left leg. Feeling the stretch here. Just take a few inhales and exhales as once again you feel the stretch. Now on the right side, envision just that long spine, that stretch moving all the way up. And let's bring it back to center. And let's walk those fingers out as far as they will go, opening up the fingers, really opening up the shoulders here. Take an inhale. And with the exhale, I want you to fully put the palms down and I want you to slowly pull the upper body up. Hands are going to become shoulder distance apart. Adjust the legs to become knee distance apart. We're going to come into a few cats and cows. We're going to curl up the spine, tucking the chin in, pushing off of the hands, really stretching the shoulders here. And then let's curve the spine the opposite direction, lifting the chin. Now you're going to really feel the stretch here in the abs and in the core. Let's bring it back down. And let's curve it back up. And let's find a neutral spine here.
Let's curl the toes on the yoga mat if they're not already curled. Lift off of those knees.
And let's come into our very first down facing dog. Working those heels closer to the yoga mat. Let's bend the right knee, bend the left. Just wiggling the legs back and forth. Getting some movement, some stretching in those legs. Now, take the feet, let's spread them mat distance apart, and I want you to take your hands and walk them all the way back. Maybe the hands are still on the yoga mat, or maybe they're just slightly floating, just depending on your flexibility. And wherever you are, no worries. Right arm is going to reach up towards the ceiling, holding here. Maybe that left arm crosses over. And let's bring it back down. Let's switch sides. Left arm comes up. Right arm might cross over. And let's bring it down. Bring the 2 feet to touch. And we're going to roll it all the way up. Arms reaching out towards the ceiling. Take a big inhale here. Don't want to hit my shelves. And let's bring it all the way back down to a forward fold. Take those feet, spread them hip distance apart. Put a little bend in the knees. We're going to come into ragdoll. Bend the elbows. Hands are going to cradle those elbows. And we're going to let the upper body hang. Maybe swaying side to side, back and forth, up and down. And let's take those hands now and release them. And let's walk those hands all the way out until the heels come off and we find ourselves in a high plank position. Here in our high plank, you are more than welcome to come down to the knees. Otherwise, stay in high plank, starting to work on that core, starting to get that heart rate up. Hold here for 3, 2, let's bring it back into down facing dog. Adjust those feet as needed, working those heels closer to the yoga mat. And let's bring it back to high plank. Holding here and breathing for 3, 2. Everyone, let's bring the knees down to the yoga mat. Tuck the tailbone back a little bit so that we adjust. And then we slowly rise on up. And we're going to come on up off of the knees. Chest is going to rise. And we're going to reach up towards the ceiling. Right hand is going to grab that left wrist. Let's lean it over to the left. And let's bring it back to center. Let's switch sides. Left arm grabs the right wrist. Lean it over to the left. Really pulling that arm. And bring it back. Hands are going to come through the heart. We're going to come into a very slight back bend into camel pose. Hands are going to come to the lower part of the back, guiding here, lifting back the chest, tucking back the shoulders, and let's lean it back, just gently and slowly. We don't want to overextend here. And let's bring it back up. Hands are going to come to the heart. I want you to ground that left knee, that left leg, finding it in a sturdy place. I want you to take that right leg, and I want you to kick it out to the side, stretching it out. Heel will connect to the yoga mat. From here, I want that right hand to slide down the leg until you feel the stretch in that inner thigh and down into the hamstring. Once you've gotten there, maybe you can go to the toes. Don't let that chest sink in. Keep that left shoulder lifted up and bring that left arm up. Hold for 3, 2. Slowly bring it back up. Right arm will come up. Hands are going to come to the heart. Take that right leg and slide it back in. Let's switch sides. Left leg is going to come out. Left heel finds connection to the yoga mat. Left hand will slide down, whether it stays at the knee, the shin, or maybe it's finding those toes. Right arm will reach up, or right arm can stay down to the side. Hold here and breathe for 3, 2. Let's release, left arm comes up. Let's bring the hands to the heart, left leg comes down. Let's bring it back into tabletop. Hands come down to the yoga mat, curl the toes on the yoga mat, and let's lift off. Woo, I just said yoga mat a lot in that sentence. Holding here, take an inhale. And with the exhale, look at your thumbs, bend your knees, and let's get to the top of our yoga mat. Staying down for a forward fold. And let's roll it all the way up. Arms reaching up towards the ceiling. Hands are gonna come through the heart. Let's open them up into cactus pose. And let's lean it back just a little bit here. Continuing to warm up that spine. Bring the arms back together, back to heart. And let's bring it all the way down. Making sure we're starting to get a really good stretch in those legs. From here, take an inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, let's step it back, coming into our high plank position. Hold in high plank here. And let's lower down to our first chaturanga. Knees can come down to the yoga mat as we shift the body forward, bending the elbows and bringing it all the way down. Inhale to up facing dog. And exhale, down facing dog. Let's flow through that again. Bring it back to high plank. Down to low plank, chaturanga. Inhale to up facing dog. Exhale, down facing dog. Let's blow it one more time. Getting that heart rate nice and warmed up. Bring it back to high plank. Getting that heart rate up high, not warmed up. Let's bring it down to chaturanga. Inhale to up facing dog. And exhale, down facing dog. Let's take an inhale. With the exhale, right leg is going to come up towards the ceiling, bending that right knee, opening the hip, and take that right leg and let's bring it in between the hands. Staying down for a little lunge, left knee is going to come down to the yoga mat. Arms are going to reach up, and we're going to come into a twist. Right arm is going to come back, and we're going to twist over to the right side. Left arm will come out, and your gaze, your eyes are going to be over that right shoulder. Hold for 3, 2. Let's bring it back. holding here. This is your modification. Or we're going to step it up coming into crescent lunge. Finding your balance here. And hold. Taking a few inhales here. Stay right here. Or we're going to twist once again. Right arm is going to come back. Opening up here. Remember, you can be on that left knee for your modification. Right arm is going to come back up. And we're going to take that left heel and we're going to flatten it down. We're going to come into warrior one. Left heel is flat. Hips are still nice and square. Arms are going to come up. Now, arms are going to come into eagle pose. Right arm is going to come underneath, connecting here, or you can keep your hands at prayer. Staying in warrior one. Let's lean it back just a little bit. And now we're going to bring those eagle arms forward, bringing them down to the knee or maybe a little bit further. Hold for 3, 2. Let's bring it back up. And let's unravel those arms and we're going to open that left hip up, coming into warrior two. Let's reverse the warrior right, palm flips up, lean it back, back to warrior two. Take that right knee, straighten it out. We're going to come into triangle pose. Upper body shifts forward, right hand comes down to that knee, shin, maybe the ankle, or take that right hand and bring it inside that right foot. Hold here for 3, 2. Let's bring it back up. Let's bend that knee, bringing it back to warrior two. Let's reverse the warrior. Back to warrior two. Take the left heel, the left arm. Let's bring it all the way back up to crescent lunge. Holding here. And let's blow it out. Hands are going to come through the heart. Right leg is going to come back. Coming in high to low plank. Inhale to up facing dog. Exhale down facing dog. Let's look at our thumbs, bend our knees, and let's get to the top of our yoga mats. Staying down for a forward fold. I keep shifting sides on my yoga mat just so that you have a better view of what's happening. And that way you're not looking at my backside the whole time. Let's take an inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. And roll it all the way up. Arms reaching up. I tell you this just in case you get a little confused as to why I'm facing opposite directions. Interlace the fingers, reaching up towards the ceiling, and let's lean it back. Really starting to feel the bend in that lower back, but leading with the chest. Don't sink all the way into the lower back there. And let's bring it back forward. Take an inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, let's step it back. Or float, bringing it in high to low plank. Inhale to up facing dog. Exhale, down facing dog. Stay for inhale. And with the exhale, take the left leg. Let's do everything on that left side. Open up that left hip, toes are flexed. Take that left leg and bring it in between the hands. And right knee comes down. Arms are gonna come up. And take that left arm and swing it back. Opening up the chest here, coming into a nice spinal twist. And let's bring it back up. Stay right where you are, or we're going to rise on up, coming into crescent lunge. Feeling that nice stretch here, and we're going to come into another spinal twist. Left arm once again will come back, opening up. Remember, you can modify and bring that right knee or just keep that right knee down. Left arm comes back up. Holding here. Let's take that right heel and flatten it out. Coming into warrior one. Hands are going to come out into a T. We're going to come into eagle arms left side. Left arm comes under, right arm on top. Interlacing those hands. Or hands can stay at prayer. You decide. From here, we bring those arms down, bringing it inside that left knee, or bringing it maybe a little bit lower down. Keeping that right foot flat. Don't let it lift off. Right foot stays grounded. Hold for 3, 2. Let's bring it all the way back up. And let's open it all the way up to warrior two. Left arm flips up. Let's bring it back to reverse warrior. And back to warrior two. Let's come into triangle pose, left side. Straighten out that left knee and upper body shifts. Left hand comes down to the thigh, past the knee to the shin or ankle, or maybe checking in on your flexibility. It comes all the way down. Right arm comes up. Holding here for three, two, and let's bring it all the way back up. Let's bend that left knee into warrior two and bring it all the way back up to crescent lunge. From here, let's flow it out. Hands are gonna come through the heart. Let's bring it all the way down. Left leg comes back. Flowing it high in a little plank. Inhale to up facing dog. And exhale down facing dog. Let's look at our thumbs, bend our knees, and let's get to the top of our yoga mat. Staying down for a forward fold. And let's roll it all the way up. Arms reaching up towards the ceiling. Hands are going to come to the heart. Let's come into chair pose. Knees are bent. We're going to come into spinal twists yet again. Upper body will come down. Left elbow will come outside that right knee. Arms are going to open up wide. Holding here. If side crow is in your practice, feel free to go. Otherwise, stay for five, four, three, two. Bring the hands back to center and let's switch sides. Let's take it over to the left. Right elbow comes outside that right knee and we open it up. Holding here. If once again side crow is in your practice, feel free to go. Otherwise, hold and breathe for five, four, three, two. Bring it back to center and let's forward fold. Take an inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold, roll it all the way up. Arms reaching up towards the ceiling. And bring that all the way back down, making sure the spine is nice and loose. Take an inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, let's step or float it back, bringing it in high to low plank. Inhale to up facing dog. And exhale, down facing dog. Let's take that right leg, bring it up towards the ceiling, bend that right knee, open up that hip. And let's take that right leg, bring it in between the hands, and staying down. Feel that low lunge. From here, we're gonna step it up into airplane pose. Right knee will lift us off and left leg comes back. Now, if you want to, you can come all the way up and then find the balance. You decide, or you can just meet us in crescent lunge, okay? So we're here floating in airplane pose. Palms are facing back. Chest is nice and square. Left toes are flexed towards the yoga mat. Hold here. And now take that left leg and bring it back. Coming into crescent lunge. Take an inhale. Now with that exhale, take that left leg and step it up, creating a nice little gap between the right foot and the left. We're coming into pyramid pose. You can act as if you're standing on a tightrope, or you can leave a little bit of space, just depending on your balance and stability. Arms are gonna come up by the ears, and let's take it forward, reaching all the way forward, making sure that that left hip doesn't sink back. It stays nice and straight. Working that nose closer to the knee. Hold and breathe for three, two. Let's bring it back up, pyramid pose. Holding here, bend that right knee just a little bit, and we're gonna launch ourselves up into warrior three. And when I mean launch, I don't mean hop or step up or jump up. I mean simply just take a nice little step off of that left leg. Arms are up by the ears, and hands are gonna come to the heart. Left leg is gonna come down. Let's bring it into a forward fold. Take it in halfway lift. Exhale, let's step or float it back, bringing it in high to low plank. Inhale to up facing dog.
And exhale, down facing dog. Let's take that left leg, bring it up towards the ceiling. Let's keep it in a three-legged dog for just a second. And then bend that left knee, open the hip. Making sure to not skip that crucial step of that flexibility and strength right there. Take that left leg and bring it in between the hands. And stay down for a low lunge. Now, we lift ourselves off that left leg, or that right leg, coming into airplane pose, palms are facing down. Or you can simply step it up, coming into crescent lunge. Or stand up and then come into the leg balance. You decide. It is your practice. Wherever you are, everyone, let's meet in crescent lunge. Taking a big inhale here. And with the exhale, just take a light little step with that right leg, coming in to pyramid pose. Align and adjust as needed, making sure that right hip doesn't sink back. Make sure it's nice and square. Arms are up by the ears, and let's bring it forward, coming into pyramid pose. Working towards that nose to the knee. And you're gonna hold here for 3, 2, and let's bring it back up. Bend that left knee a little bit, and once again, we lift ourselves off, keeping the arms up by the ears and coming into warrior 3. Hands are gonna come to the heart. We bring that right leg down and bring it all the way down into a forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Let's roll it all the way up. Arms reaching up towards the ceiling. Hands are gonna come to the heart. And we pause. Take an inhale. With the exhale, let's take those legs and spread them about mat distance apart. Not too wide with the toes. We want to keep them nice and open as we come into our first sumo squat. We're going to do two sumo squats. One up, come down. One up, come down. And then on the last one, we're going to come all the way down into our yogi squat. Or you can just stay in sumo squat. So for our first sumo squat, chest lifted, hands are at the heart. And we slowly just come down, lifting the chest and squat down. Hold here and breathe. Breathe, breathe, breathe. From here, let's rise it up, stretching those legs, squeezing the glutes as you rise up. Take an inhale. And with the exhale, let's lower back down for number 2. Holding here, letting yourself feel the stretch for 3, 2. And let's bring it back up. This last round, bring it down into a yogi squat if you would like to. Hips are gonna come all the way down. You can grab a yoga block to sit on or simply just lower yourself down. Keeping that chest nice and lifted. We're gonna be here for about 20 seconds. If you'd like to practice your crow pose, now is your time to do so. Otherwise, you can go check out my other YouTube videos on how to float a crow. Or just stay right where you are. We have about 10 more seconds to go. Holding here and breathing. For 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. If you floated in crow pose, let's bring it down into yogi squat. Everyone else, hands come down, and let's slowly rise up. Let's bend the right leg, bend the left, and let's bring the 2 feet to touch. And let's roll it all the way up. Arms reaching up towards the ceiling. Hands are gonna come to the heart.
I didn't get that.
Let's take a big inhale up. Hands are gonna come to the heart. And we find ourselves in mountain's pose, standing rest, or sasana. And we breathe. Feel free to pause the video, grab a drink of water if you would like to. We're gonna come into a few leg balances next, so you can scoot the yoga mat closer to the wall if you'd like to, or just close the eyes and catch the breath. We're gonna take an inhale here. Like I said, pause and take a moment for as long as you need to, but for the sake of time, we're gonna move forward. Let's bring the palms down, opening them up. Take an inhale here.
And exhale. And let's take a big inhale, reach up towards the ceiling. And hands come back down to the heart. Let's ground that left leg. We're gonna take that right knee and we're gonna bring it up. We're just gonna start off with a nice slow stretch. Right hand is gonna grab that right knee. We're gonna pull it up towards the chest and we're gonna simply open it up.
We're not going to extend here. What I want you to do instead is release that hand, squeeze that leg muscle as we open it up here, and then I want you to slowly kick out that right leg. Hold and breathe for 3, 2.
Bend that right knee back up, bring it back forward, and place it down. Just a simple movement to get the balancing a little bit more.
Ground the right leg, left knee comes up.
Left hand grabs that left knee, and we open it up here.
Right hand is more than welcome to come to the waist.
Let's release that left hand. Hands can come to the heart as we kick out that left side. Hold and breathe for 3, 2, and let's bring it back forward and bring it down. Let's come down into a forward fold and roll it all the way up. Arms reaching up, let's keep the big inhale up. Hands are gonna stay up. We're gonna come into dancer's pose.
Left hand is gonna stay up. Right leg is gonna come up and then it's gonna come back.
Right hand is going to grab any part of that foot or ankle. And as we slowly find the balance,
we're going to start leaning the chest forward.
Left hand is going to come forward, bringing the upper body. Right toes are flexed, and we find ourselves in dancer's pose. Holding here for 3, 2. Let's bring it back up. And hands come to the heart and we bring it down. Let's take an inhale up. Hands come to the heart and let's come into dancer's pose, left side. Right arm stays up, left knee comes towards the chest and then we bring that left leg back. Grabbing that left knee, chest is lifted, toes are flexed. And we simply just start leaning it forward. Pushing against that left arm. Hold and breathe for 3, 2. And let's bring it back up. Just simple movement here. Hands come to the heart. And we bring it down. Let's bring it all the way down to a forward fold. And take an inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold, roll it all the way up. Arms reaching up towards the ceiling. Hands come to the heart. We're just gonna do one round of tree pose today.
Ground that left leg, right knee opens up. We find ourselves either at the ankle, the shin, upper thigh, or we come into half lotus.
You decide. Hands are at the heart. Finding our balance here, wherever your tree is. Interlace those fingers, reach up towards the ceiling.
Relax the shoulders. Maybe take your gaze up towards the ceiling, chin included. Bring it up.
Hold here for 3, 2. Now stay in your tree. Bring the gaze back down. Hands are going to open up into a V or a Y. And we're going to take the upper body and we're going to come into another twist.
Bringing the upper body over to the right side.
Keeping the balance here, hold for 3, 2,
let's bring it back. Let's take it over to the left.
And bring it back to center. Hands come to the heart. Take that right knee, bring it forward and lift it up. I want you to kick that right leg forward, straightening it out. Hold here and breathe for 3, 2,
now, either bring that right leg down or cross it over. Don't let it touch that foot or touch the yoga mat.
And then bring it back up and simply bring it back down. Let's bring it down into a forward fold. Take an inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold, roll all the way up. Arms reaching up towards the ceiling. Hands are going to come to the heart. Let's tree pose, left side. Ground that right knee, right leg. Bend that left knee and bring it to the ankle, shin, upper thigh, or half lotus. Today, I'm just keeping mine at a simple calf. Simply because when your body gets used to a certain pose, mix it up, change it up. That way it becomes a little more challenging and you find your muscles working a little bit harder because they're not used to being in this pose. Once you're there, interlace those fingers, reach up towards the ceiling and shift your gaze up. And let's bring it back forward. Hands are going to come to the heart. Finding your balance here. Arms come out to a T or to a V or a Y.
We're going to take the upper body this time over to the left side.
And bring it back. Let's take it over to the right. And let's bring it back.
Hands come to the heart. Take that left knee,
bring it up. Let's kick that left leg forward. Holding here for 3, 2. Now bring that left leg down
or cross it over, crossing over the right leg. Just let it barely touch the yoga mat
and then bring it back up and bring it back down. Let's bring it all the way down to a forward fold. Take an inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, let's step or float it back, bringing it in high to low plank. Inhale to up facing dog. Exhale, down facing dog. Stay for inhale. And as you exhale, right leg comes up towards the ceiling. Bend that right knee, open the hip. And we're gonna take that right leg and we're gonna bring it on the outside of that right arm. Coming into a really deep stretch. Left knee is more than welcome to come down to the yoga mat or keep it up. As we work the lower body further down, you can bring the elbows down and connecting to the forearms. Hold here and breathe, breathe, breathe. For 3, 2. If you are on your forearms, bring it back up. Take that right leg and bring it back behind the wrist. Lengthening out for half pigeon. On the right side, try to not sink over to that right side. Try to square those hips as much as you can and bring the upper body down. Coming to the forearms, or if you would like to, you can bring it all the way down. And here we just breathe. We take a few inhales in and exhale out.
Inhale in.
Clearing the mind, exhale out. This is one of these stretches that you can just stay in for as long as you would like to. Feel free to pause the video and just let your body feel how deep or how much it needs this stretch. And then if you want, we can move along or you just stay right where you are. For sake of time, we're gonna come on up. Hands are gonna come to the yoga mat. Curl the toes on the left foot and bring that right leg up. We're just going to kick it around, coming into a few donkey kicks here, making sure we're nice and warmed up. And let's bring it back into a down facing dog. Take an inhale here. And with the exhale, bring that left leg up towards the ceiling. Bend that left knee, open the hip, and take the left leg and bring it inside, or bring it on the outside of the left hand. Right knee, remember, can bring you down. Or they are up, and we're gonna bring it down to the forearms just to deepen the stretch. Hold here, and breathe. Hands come on up. Let's come into half pigeon, left side.
Work the leg back behind the wrist,
and lengthen out that right leg.
And let's bring it down.
Trying to not sink over to the left side too much, making sure we're nice and open in those hips as we bring it down. And we find ourselves breathing once again. Now let's bring the arms back up. Remember, you can stay here as long as you would like. Curl the toes on that right foot, and let's bring that left leg up, giving it a few donkey kicks to get the kinks out. And let's bring it back to a down facing dog.
Now, I want you to know we're going to be coming into a seated position. So you can shift the upper body forward and you can just walk your hands through the legs. Or you can do a little hop or float. Take an inhale here. And as you exhale, let's get through the hands. And arms are going to come up. Hands are going to come to the heart. And we're slowly just going to come onto our backs. Interlacing those fingers and give yourself a full body stretch here. Opening up the ribs. Let's bend those knees. Coming into our last few rounds of asanas, our back bends, our inversions, and ending with our shavasanas. We're going to bend those knees and we're going to come into either bridge pose or will. You decide. Choose what's best for your practice. I'm going to stay in bridge today. Hands are going to come back behind to the ankles. And we're just going to take an inhale with the exhale. We're going to take those hips and lift them off, really working that spine. If you're coming into will, hands are back by the shoulders and we push our thumbs off. We're just going to stay here for about 20 seconds or so. If you'd like to go a little bit further, take those heels off of the yoga mat and work them closer up. Holding here and breathing. Breathe, breathe, breathe. If you'd like to, you can take the right leg, bring it up towards the ceiling. And let's bring it down. Let's switch sides. Left leg is up. And bring it down. Everyone, take the hips wherever you are and bring them down to the yoga mat. And let's bring those knees to the chest. And let's rock side to side. Making sure to feel the pressure of the yoga mat on the lower part of the back. Now, for our last round of asanas, we always come into our inversions to circulate good blood flow and making our bodies feel nice and youthful. Simply all we have to do is take the legs and bring them up, placing them either on a wall or just keep them straight up in the air. You decide. You can place a yoga block or a yoga blanket, any blanket, underneath the lower part of your back for support. You can come into headstand, handstand, shoulder stand, forearm stand. I'm going to come into shoulder stand. We can do a tutorial on headstand or a more advanced practice in our inversions later. Now, simply coming into our shoulder stand, we take an inhale here, and we simply bring it back onto our lower backs using the hand we'd like you to guide us up. Lifting up here, hands come to the lower part of our back, and we simply straighten the legs out. Now, we can bring this into plow, bringing the toes back behind the head. If your legs are just up the wall, feel free to stay. You're just fine. Remember to close the eyes down and let yourself breathe. Working those toes closer to the yoga mat. Maybe those hands want to come back to the feet. Feeling the stretch here. Everyone, wherever you are, bring those legs straight up. Let's take those legs into a wide V. And let's take the right leg and cross it over. We always end our practice this way. You can come into eagle legs. Simply to keep the movement flowing. And bring it back to a wide V. And let's cross over the left leg, either at the ankle, lady legs, or eagle pose. We did eagle arms today. We might as well join in on the eagle legs as well. And let's release. And let's slowly bring it down. All the way down. If you were in a headstand, handstand, or forearm stand, bring it into child's pose. Otherwise, let's slowly everyone else come into happy baby. Grabbing the outside of the feet or wrapping the peace fingers around. And we rock side to side. Making sure to feel the pressure of the yoga mat on the lower back. Holding those legs closer to the ground. And let's bring the knees in, give them a nice squeeze here. And let's straighten those legs out, coming into Shavasana, relaxation. Arms come down to the side. So this is a great time for you to grab an article of clothing to put back on socks, maybe something to cover your eyes, anything to just help you feel a little bit more relaxed. When we're in our Shavasana, we come into a meditative state
and we focus on nothing but the breath.
We take an inhale in and we use the exhale to send out any thoughts that we might have.
We just want to exist. We just want to be. And we find ourselves in Shavasana for as long as you would like to. And we simply just exist and let our bodies and let our minds relax through everything that we've done. Like I said, you can either pause this video and stay in Shavasana for as long as you would like to. But we will continue on for the sake of time. We're going to come into a seated position after waking up the body, wiggling the fingers and wiggling the toes and moving them around. And then whenever you are ready, come on up into a seated position of your choice. Hands are going to come to the heart. We're going to take a big inhale in, coming full circle back to the breath. Exhale it out.
Let's do this one more time. Take an inhale in
and exhale out. Thank you so much for being with me today. I hope you enjoyed this yoga flow.
And let's bring our chins down to our chest. And together we say, namaste.
Thank you again so much for joining me. I hope you have a wonderful day. Thank you, everyone.